Yeah, I believe so. There's a lot of negative stigma with that character. A lot of people think she's very boring to watch. A lot of people think she's too safe, which, like, because everyone likes the high action, the high trades, you know. Exactly.
The chic. Little black.
Yeah, and then Rosalina, like, when you lose Luma, it's almost like they stall it out a bit, they wait for them to come back, and...
But you just have to, you know, you gotta wonder, is that the kind of gameplay that we want to...
Yeah.
That's something that really have to think, is that where we're wanting to go?
And so we got Dreamland, which is good for Zeus because of the lower ceiling, but also means rest kills even earlier if they can land those. And then the backer already, the Jigglypuff is so difficult to get back on the stage. You have a really good Jigglypuff on the other team.
Yeah. Maybe that's why you pick Villager, because Villager's recovery, although nerf, is also extremely good.
Yeah, because if one backer, when you're a Mario, and you can't make it back. When Jigglypuff just gets out, but with Villager, he has such good recovery, that it takes so much more effort by Jigglypuff.
Oh, he drops a bowling ball of Robear, but locked. And he might be gone.
Uh-oh. Jirsu's down. And,
look at that
gimp! Wow.
Oh, that was beautiful.
That was a really good... I believe every third down aerial by Villager is a meteor smash. The other two aren't.
So it's just perfect timing.
Coincidence or strategy, we don't know.
We don't know. We'll find out later.
Oh, Jigglypuff dead again. So all of a sudden, Green Team had a huge lead.
We're not expected. I was going to say we have yet to see Little Mac do anything, and then he just one-shots Villager.
Yeah. He proved you wrong right there.
Right there. Vivid says, no, you shut up.
Yeah.
And Jigglypuff going flying for a trip, perhaps, in his favorite rocket ship, but makes it back down to Earth with ease. Look at Villager just going right against Little Mac. Don't see that very
often. He still is just as ham as he was as Mario.
Absolutely. You know, like, he's going in, he doesn't... Ooh, beautiful hit by Vivif onto Brobear to get him off the stage there. And here we see the control of the center stage, keeping them off.
Yeah. Well, the thing with Villager, I feel like you almost give up that middle control because he's so good off edge. And,
right.
And on, like, he's good in the air and also good on the ledge.
Look,
he can, yeah.
Yeah, absolutely.
Because he can drop down and shoot a slingshot. So,
right.
Which it kind of sucks for... You got the rest, but Villager already started his side B.
Okay.
So he couldn't punish it correctly, but
Jigglypuff
gets the kill though. Does he take it, Max?
So the question is, can Little Mac keep it in the center of the stage? Long enough to not get maybe.
If there's one character that can get these kills though off a few reads,
right?
It's Little Mac.
Absolutely. If there's a player that can play middle, Little Mac, it's Little.
Exactly.
So, and we might not be seeing that here though. He's up in the air. As we mentioned, not the greatest air game, Robear, and CSS on the other hand.
You gotta be careful though, because with the closeness of good spot dodge by Zero Suit. That would have been deadly.
Nice follow up by Churro there. Not quite enough.
Oh,
and the
beautiful.
Gimp. Well, no. To the Gimp. Wasn't it?
Yeah.
It was a smash.
Yeah. It's always so unexpected.
It is.
Because it's so instant that you just.
Yeah.
You think something else happens.
Exactly.
And especially because he went left.
Right.
And not down because, you know, Nintendo Meteor smashes.
Right. Exactly. Thank you, Nintendo.
The guy punches them downward, they fly up, you know?
Yeah. Well, it's because, you know, that kinetic energy it reverses when it hits a, you know, a polarized object or something. Techno battle.
Yeah.
Look at that! What a beautiful combo.
This is honestly getting a little scary though, because Zero Suit is pretty much at death percent versus Little Mac. And Villager is not able to really get some, like, they're not really playing as the team. Like, it's not like the
weakest team. It's really hard to see, like, man, look at that. And this is it, it's down to the wire! Can Little Mac make it back? Oh, he dodges the hit!
Oh,
but there's the side off the edge!
Oh, good spot dodge. He makes it back.
This is
scary though.
And it does give, and it's Robear's face as the fish collides the side
great.
Of the stage.
Oh, this is
unbelievable.
Absolutely terrifying.
Vivid with a beautiful reset, continually staying out of the sights of that beautiful up air from Robear. But he gets him with a nice kick to the face, shoots him off the side.
After this game, I just want to see how long Jigglypuff has been out. Because he's been playing this 1v2, now 1v1, for so long. Oh, and the good side smash!
Oh, but he's on the wrong side of the stage!
Oh, but Little Mac's recovery!
Doesn't matter! Should have played Mario.
Should
have played Mario. And the little Mac has unfortunately let us down just
a little bit. Just a little bit, but
not at all in the combat area, but definitely in that recovery.
Oh yeah. So Funai Bros. 5 wins away from taking grand finals, because they've got to get 2 more and then 3 more. So they've got a long path ahead of them, but
long.
And it is terrifying to know that that Jigglypuff was dead for 2-3 minutes, and they almost lost the 2v1. Like,
with, and you switch back to Rosalina, so how much more terrifying is that?
Oh, it's absolutely, like, because this Rosalina is so safe, like, it's going to be the opposite, I feel, because she's going to be surviving a lot longer.
Right.
And if little Mac can survive as long as he did in the first game, this is not looking very good for the
way that I see this win is the same way that they've won previously against the Tails and Greatness. Is they're going to have to get little Mac game soon.
Yes.
And then be able to crack down on Rosalina later, because, like you say, Rosalina is so safe. You're trying to 1v1 both of them. Little Mac's going to 1v1 whoever.
Oh, yeah.
And he's going to win that. And Rosalina's just going to play safe until it's time.
I actually really like that he's going back to Mario. It makes sense because Jigglypuff's gone.
Right.
I think that was a really good pick against the Jigglypuff because of survivability.
Yeah.
But you've got the cape now. And Churro's shown that he can use the cape to get those kills.
So we're going to see if he can use that to get Little Mac even more.
Exactly. Like, now Little Mac's survival is even lower than it used to be.
Exactly. So it's definitely going to be... but he said we weren't going to see Mario. So he said 10 games, Little Mac.
Yeah.
That's what he said.
Every single game.
So,
but if it's, you know, like, they struggled with this comp versus Jaxxus and G-Man,
right?
The three Dark Bros came back and beat Jaxxus and G-Man, so...
Right.
There's got to be a little bit of question, but it's definitely, like, that's what I think with the best of five, is you have these games that kind of test the waters if you're on the winner side.
But of course, the early starter to really win the Tails of Greatness really switched over to Mario.
Yes.
So if he's eliminated that by right of honor.
Yeah, by right of honor.
All the flex!
Oh!
Massive
beautiful read on that, because he knew Mario was approaching and just...
His face, end of stock.
Yeah.
And that's the power of Little Mac, ladies and gentlemen.
And I mean, look at Rosalina, and as we said, low percent. So even though, like, it's stock-wise even, 0-2 is almost 100, well, now 63, so about 60% up.
Yeah.
And,
once again, Yezuka did a really good smash.
Oh!
Look at that!
Beautiful play by Brobe on that one.
Brobe just... The slanted meteorite off the stage.
Yes.
So nice.
And which, what was cool about that is he used his back air to bait the air dodge so that Rosalina felt safer than she was.
Oh, and that could be... That is. No recovery. Max down again.
I killed you with style. I killed you with
style. We've seen that before. Many times in the tournament. Yeah.
We've seen it too many times, almost.
And the flexing and
look
the...
Look at that. Mario almost just throws him off with that. Just a back throw.
And that's the thing, is when you play versus Little Mac, you don't actually have to... I feel like you don't have to have the control of the middle.
Right, no. Because if he comes out to fight you...
Yeah. And then... Because really? Once he's in the air, he just does... Oh, the beautiful play! He does it again!
Almost the exact same.
He's done it now both to one to both, and Little Mac takes Rosalina's stock, which we also saw earlier.
Oh, Little Mac. And hit there, and it's...
He's really got to make something out of that stock. Like,
he
can't get... He's, you know, he has to be able to just create something, because we're not seeing it yet.
Right, exactly.
There was the really cool KO punch earlier.
Yeah. The flex.
Yeah, the flex. But that's the last of what we saw.
Exactly.
You know?
So since then, we've seen him gimp twice.
Yes.
And it's just... If he gets too far off that stage, he's
gone. Oh, beautiful up smash, though, to take out 0-2.
And you hear the growl.
Oh, yeah. You can always tell when it's going to happen, because we hear it seconds before it actually happens.
Yeah, because he knows. He's read it. You know, he's read it in stone to him. It's already been said.
Oh, yeah.
And he knows what's going to happen. But Little Mac now completely off the table. And like we said, they get Little Mac off, so now it's just Rosalina.
Yeah.
And they might be able to double team him. You know, I'm not saying she's not strong, but she's definitely...
It's offensive. Oh, yeah. I think they're happier with these than when the Little Mac was the one left, because...
Absolutely.
I feel like just Vivid just excels in those high-pressure styles. I'm not saying Rosalina doesn't. I'm just saying the reward,
right,
the payoff, is just so huge for Little Mac.
Yeah. He's playing a character that fits his personality, I think, so well.
Oh, yeah.
And that really is important. You can do so much if you're in tune with your character.
Oh, yeah.
And,
beautiful downtimes, but this Rosalina is just... She just survived so long. Exactly. We've seen these in every game. There's a Rosalina.
Oh, that's it.
Great play by Mario. Close that out.
Really? Yep.
Out of the one of those. Game 2 going over the
Itanari Brothers.
Itanari, which origin of that name?
There's a meaning I'm not gonna say it on stream.
Oh, okay, I got you.
But
I thought maybe.
Yeah,
it sounds vaguely familiar. All right, so.
Are you kidding me?
Wait, same teams?
Well, I think they're really just gonna play out this best of the best five. Yeah. Because the Itanari Brothers are coming from the losers. So they don't, like, they technically don't lose anything if they lose another game.
Right.
Because it just resets.
Right. Absolutely.
But I really do think those are resets that we should definitely, he just switch back tomorrow.
Okay. I think so. I think if he wants to win.
Yeah. Although he does have really doubles his complexing.
Yeah, I know.
So,
right.
There's the logic, and then there's kind of like
right?
The fun.
Yeah.
Like,
and that's
I don't know.
The thing. That's what's so great about Smash is people are still having fun playing the game.
I mean, he might have gotten gimped a couple times, and then he lands a KO punch, he stands up, flexes, you know, he's...
Exactly, he's in it.
He has such a good mindset for the game.
Yeah,
like,
he does.
So we're going on Halbert. I think this is probably Zero-Suit's best stage just because the ceiling is so low that she can get that up B kill so early.
I don't exactly like the stage just the way it fits in the center and you got that platform there.
Oh yeah.
It's really counterintuitive for a lot of characters to try and land abilities through there.
But that's why like Zero-Suit doesn't really get punished by this much because she has so much range on her smashes and stuff. Oh, side smash, but Mario does live.
Yeah, the Mario recovery just 10 times better than Little Mac.
Oh, and the upbeat. Great DI by Rosalina, and also just not high enough percent. But
Churro's off the map, and in uncharted waters, but is the life of a KO. Little Mac! Oh, look at that, but doesn't KO because he's only at 5 or 6% when you hit him with that.
Oh yeah.
46 now.
I didn't actually realize that like was so much less percent. It gave so much less percent. But
Little Mac gimped again.
Oh, and then Rosalina killed off the top. Beautiful little play by both the Itanari Brothers.
Right, they're both
really good at that 1v1 we were talking about earlier.
They're good at the 1v1. And right here, I just think it's an imbalance because Rosalina doesn't really win a 1v1, but she doesn't lose. Little Mac almost always wins a 1v1.
Yeah.
So it's interesting that they had to change up their playstyle, but right there, they were back to it for a moment and they both made me play out.
And Rosalina, I think, because Rosalina obviously is considered the second best character.
Right?
Is good in the traditional 1v1s.
Churro misses!
Oh!
Doesn't land the recovery! Oh, that's really unfortunate. And
they need to get this kill on Rosalina
quickly.
Oh,
the stage is so balanced.
I still got this
fight. Because they need to definitely get these kills early.
Oh, and Little Mac.
Oh,
again, it's again.
The water. Yeah, and then they kill Rosalina. They have the soccer
now. Again, it's. And so, yeah, the lead's there for TSS, obviously, 107% on the last double stock that we have.
Oh, yeah. Oh, beautiful read by Little Mac. Great counter on him.
And beautiful hit right to
the bomb gets both of them. Which definitely.
Oh, Vivis in the air, though, and that opens up for TSS, but Vivis great GI and gets him off the side there.
Oh, yeah. They really need to. This is really tense because we've seen both teams get these sudden kills.
Oh, and he knows it's gonna happen!
Punch again!
We hear the growl!
We see him flex. We see Mario go.
And it's the 2v1 now, but ZSS is on relatively low percentage, so...
Oh, the laser bounce!
Oh, the laser bounce was good. And if she can get...
If she can kill that back,
Oh, maybe? That might be enough.
Those hits are doing a lot of percent and a lot of knockback. And it's just... I mean, he's got Luma and
Luma hit him! Luma set that up. So nice.
The thing is, Zero-Suit's just everywhere with her mobility on the stage. But he needs to definitely make something happen sooner than later.
Right, he's just racking up damage currently.
Oh!
Whoa! And we hear the growl, we see the flex, and we hear the flinching of his enemies.
Exactly.
Vivith brings it through again.
So that was interesting because even though that stage was really good for Zero-Suit, I think you brought up a really good point, the dip in the center. Because it kind of made it extra safe for Millibag.
Yeah, because he was always going into those instead of going off the side.
Exactly, he could tag off of the ramps there.
Right.
And it really, I mean, he was living longer, he was punishing much better.
And every time he died, it was because his recovery is bad.
Yeah.
So he wasn't losing trades, it was just because he would get up in the air, off the side, that's it.
Yeah. And when he gets a high enough percent, that's going to happen.
Exactly.
So, That was really, that was kind of cool to see how that's, he really used that stage 2 as his advantage.
Yeah.
On the footing run, he did not leave the middle.
Right, absolutely, no. He was very good at staying in the middle, and I think it's kind of different because we saw him almost on the edges previously and Rosalina in the middle. And now it's kind of reverse. Rosalina's trying to set up these hits.
Yeah.
And, I think it was all three of Churro's stalks went away to that punch.
Yes.
With the flux and the grip.
The second one didn't kill him. But you're right.
No, yeah.
He is landing them.
Right, absolutely. He landed at least three.
Yeah, and he got two stocks. I mean, you're happy with that. You know, that's really good because, I mean, he was hitting him at like 60%. You know, those were some low kills he was getting.
Absolutely.
And it's a mindset because you get in the head of the opponent because this is like, it's
especially with the flex.
Exactly. And it's a fairly telegraphed move. And so when you get hit by that, you're just like, oh my gosh, how did that happen to me?
Churro going back to the villager, so maybe he's
probably the worst stage for Mac, in my opinion. Because you've got platforms, you've got...
And slanting the other way this time.
Yeah, you've got even harder recovery options with the tilting map, right?
Ooh.
The trade-off, though, is that this is a really good stage for Rosalina, though, because she has so much room to maneuver around. And her recovery is so good anyways that it doesn't matter if the stage is tilting.
Right. Oh, almost broke Robert's shield there. But not quite. Vivid up in the air, but not on the side. And Churro getting beat.
Luma down. Luma at 80%. This is when Green Team really needs to make a move right here.
Right, they need to get the double KO there and then work on the next stocks already. Oh, nice jump by Vivid to stop that. Oh, collision in the air. A little friendly fire going from Churro to Robert.
Oh,
Max far, but he's going to make that recovery. Oh, but Rosalina. No Luma. She's out of there. It's done.
Exactly. They really capitalized on that back of Luma right there. That was beautiful.
Oh, look at that. Robert
is just surviving. That was a really...
Beautiful
smash. Beautiful smash.
So
knowing
good.
Those recovery options are so limited by Little Mac. You really read it correctly, and just beautiful punish.
He knew he'd already basically used everything he could. He could only go for the stage grab, so just charge up that smash, and boom.
Exactly.
Perfect timing by Churro there.
Oh, and Little Mac already up in the air, but he's too low percent to get killed. I really like the villager switch. Because as we were talking about, the recovery is a little wonky on the stage,
right?
So it gives you some good zoning, which is really good against Mac. And it also gives you, like, you're not afraid of this map anymore,
right?
You know, because Mario has a very static upbeat.
Shows out of there. Get hit by the up smash by Ninetales.
So it's 2-all. It kind of looks like when everybody's at 3-stocks, where Mac was at 5%, Rosalina was at medium.
Whoa! Look at that!
Whoa! Max lives!
Oh, he makes it.
People have been DIing this very efficiently today. Like,
they have been. They've been really going...
so many times I think they're done, and then
I keep thinking, because every time... So many times we've seen Brokeback over that, and he just... Like there, and...
There we go.
That's
there
what
we go.
Too high percent to DI. No,
that's what we've been expecting
exactly.
This whole time, so...
That's absolutely fantastic as it goes through there, and...
Robert really tried to hit Luma there because his Rosalina was on the edge to kill her, but couldn't convert it.
Nice skip by... Oh no, there's a Meteor. He did it again! Down in media to...
I'm wondering if they changed it because I'm seeing that a lot more.
But maybe it's more often.
Yeah.
Maybe it's a 30% chance and not every third.
Or it might just be reliable now. I'll have to ask us after these sets because we won't interrupt them.
Oh, he throws Vivid off the side and the recovery is there just enough.
I really like that side beat though.
The shield almost breaks on Little Mac. It does break on Little Mac!
Gets the kill. Rosalina now. Huge uphill battle.
If the Fujinari brothers win this one, it's the game of the first fives. That's gonna be.
They get that reset.
Yeah, they get that reset, and they're gonna go into the actual grand final. So very convincing here so far. Rosalina 52%.
I just really love this stage choice. I think this is perfect.
Absolutely, let's go.
And now we've reset the bracket.
Right,
grand finals. Food and Rose was Tales of Greatness. I know he said. I guess those are the singles,
yeah. Those are the singles.
I know that he said he would stay Mac. You know, like.
He said he would stay Little Mac. We're not seeing it. He lied.
Oh, he's Mario? Yeah.
He lied.
I mean, when you lose the first set, we won.
Yeah.
If it was a 3-2, really close.
Maybe
but that last game, both of them had 2 stocks up. They were 5%, but it wasn't like 150. You know, it was like 80, 90.
Yeah.
You kind of want that consistency back. Because there's so many times that like there's a death via the water from Mario.
Right.
Like, you're getting these kills that only work on Little Mac.
Yeah. And, you know, he looks like he might be taking off the shades of red, white, and blue and putting on the shades of truth. The truth is,
Yeah. That's the thing. It's the same thing with Ike, is you have these options to really punish well and punish hard.
Right.
But they're low. They're lower tier for a reason.
Yeah, exactly. Because
they lack these other options, like Lomax's recovery is bad, his aerials are bad, Ike is slow and predictable.
Yep.
And that's why they're not the top tier.
Exactly. That's something else. You know, the top tier characters, they all have kind of like this checkbox of like, okay, I have all this cool stuff, but I also have these basic things that I'm going to have. You know, I have recovery, I have some air game, you know, maybe I have really powerful setup.
And it's definitely how Nintendo made Sheiks. they took out the checkbox, they went down. No. Because they did give her like a hard time to kill, which actually people think... Some people think Rosalina's the best, actually, over Sheik in the 1v1, because she has those good kill opportunities.
Right.
It's just, there's not enough tournaments with Rosalina yet, and Zero, who main Sheik, wins everything.
Yeah,
so it's hard to really see the tournament results yet, but...
Yeah, I absolutely agree, and, you know, the thing is, I feel like the fact that Sheik has a hard time KOing really comes into play in the lower tier, or extremely high.
Yes.
Like, there's a tier in there where it's kind of like, well, if you make a mistake, she's still gonna send you off the mat. So,
yeah.
I
absolutely agree.
Yeah, and like, just get the checkbox and that's gonna be me. Nope, Mario comes back, the Mario. The red, white, and blue Mario is down. He's up 130%.
These Zero Suit is just getting some really good punches. Then up there on the Mario, then goes into the next attack to get Rosalina. Very fluid.
Look at that! Goes for the Gimp on Vivith, but gets returned with a great up air from...
Oh, beautiful back throw. Rosalina still lives, and then Zero Suit actually is the one to die first.
Yeah, but then Rosalina follows that up quite quickly. Vivith now on the highest percentage. They're going to want to be getting him out of here, especially since Mario.
Oh, back throw.
Oh, but not a kill, goes up this, and he's not going to quite snag it. Vivith coming in from the side, looks for the Gimp, he goes for it, he's not going to break it. He's now on the ledge guard, and Brobear is OP, but he gets interrupted by Luna.
Oh, and the blue Mario goes down.
Oh, man.
Actually, it looked like Zero Suit. The second hit of the smash. And that's the thing, is that was a really, like, I don't know if it was intentional, but it's all that chaos.
Yeah, all that chaos. He found Mario. I thought for sure he was going to hit Rosalina, but Rosalina was just out of the way. It went through and hit right into Vivith, and that was unbelievable.
And I think it only hit him because Rosalina air dodged, so it didn't create the lag.
Exactly.
So, I mean, that's the kind of the beauty of the doubles. You have all this action going on that it's, no matter, like, how good and how clutched you are,
this is, yeah, I mean, and this...
What?
Are you playing up singles?
Yeah.
Zero, Shy versus Starling,
Robear
versus Summer Heat, Joe versus G-Man, Zila versus Taito,
good luck, Summer.
Video versus Wolf versus Sammy versus RCS Jr., versus Wolfie, Ninja Sashi versus Jackson, Shari versus...
You might have to set soul. Well, it depends. I could probably have it set. Because we won't have that many TVs, you know?
Right. Yeah, there's going to be so many matches to be played in that. I'm not set up and solo at all, so.
Oh, so you just hit a call. You got this.
This is what I'm here for. Oh, and speaking of commentating, get back to this Rosalina off the stage, 130%.
Oh, beautiful.
So,
and that's
nice.
The thing, Rosalina's recovery is really good, and then he loses, but it doesn't hit any. You know, there's no hit.
Right.
So if you predict the pathing,
getting information here from the back row.
Exactly.
Zeno, such a great game knowledge, bringing us into this tournament, and I just. In this people in this tournament, there's so much knowledge here.
Oh yeah,
he's going around, he talks to Brobear, Texas, Zeno.
Yeah. They'll be so friendly about helping you out. That because,
exactly.
For example, since I'm relatively new to the cut, because I played, there was no customs. And it's really friendly because how they set it up is, if you don't know the customs, they'll show you them. They'll go into a game before you start, And it's like, okay, look, here's how my fireball works. Here's how my upbeats change.
Right.
Mario, you know, Mario switches. Right, Fruit Arrow is going up 1-0, though.
Yeah, right.
I'm a little shocked because the Rosalina and Mario combo was so deadly versus Jackson and G-Man.
Right.
But Turo had 2 stocks left.
Absolutely.
And Zero Suit was at 1 stock when Rosalina was at 2.
Right.
Punisher got her down to 1, and then they just cleverly brought it back. So...
I think it's really fantastic, and like you say, a lot of times people will just be like, hey, check out the
yeah.
And, of course, that doesn't matter much to me, so I
don't know. Yeah, exactly.
I'm going to KO it in 2 seconds anyway.
Alright, so Battlefield, pretty much good for everybody, so this is really going to come down to coordination, and just who makes the least mistakes, you know?
Yeah.
It's so plain to say.
Right.
But when you have all this action going on, as we've been saying with the chaos, it's so easy just to lapse through that 1 second.
Well, that almost gets the double up on Vivid, but Rosalina, beautiful interrupt.
Oh, yeah.
Takes the hit for Vivid.
Oh! It's usually going for the...
Excellent upbeat.
Low percent, but...
Yeah, that was...
We take that percent.
Exactly. We take it. No quarter given right now. And the Luma might be gone. I think the Luma is gone. They're going to try to focus down Rosalina now. That is indeed the Luma off the stage. Now it's the 1v1.
Oh! Off the 1v1.
And there's the 1 hit!
The kill. Actually didn't survive like we usually see.
Yeah.
I'm so used to seeing them fly to the corner.
Yeah, and they just kind of
live. Yeah. But, so, a lead already for Green Team. Mario, yep. Churro's at such a low percent, like, it's so weird because he's playing so aggressive.
Mm-hmm. But it seems like
it's so
straight. Yeah, it really is. Like, he's giving him no counterplay. He's not saying, oh, here's a trade. He's saying, oh, I'm hitting you, and you don't get to do anything.
Yeah.
And it's definitely...
Robert mistimed his, the chain.
Right.
Or not chain, but the grab hook.
Okay.
And actually didn't grab the ledge with it. He did it a little too early, so he actually lost the stock a tad early, but...
And that's going to be Rosalina going off, so it's 2-all except for Churro. Churro's got 3 stocks there.
Vivid. Beautiful interrupt.
Oh, look at this!
Oh!
Couldn't quite make it back to the final up smash.
But the beautiful part of that is that he gave Churro all that time to get back. And now look at Churro's back in the middle of the stage again.
Yep.
Mario took all that extra percent. Seriously, still a low percent. And,
Oh, and they're both going
way. Oh!
The Mario and Mario action! And Vivid, not gonna make it! That's a sad
reaction because they both got hit by the same attack.
Yes.
But Churro saw it first and just took that small opening he got and really capitalized on it.
We were talking about this Vivid versus Churro. Vivid directly called out the Churro Mario play, but we're not seeing the talk backed up by anything right now. Right now, Churro is. Oh, no, it's a great smash.
A lot of action. I think he was definitely trying to go. Oh, beautiful read on this Rosalina up smash.
Oh, my goodness.
3 stocks, Churro.
This Churro is unbelievable.
He's really sad. At the beginning, it was a little rocky, but ever since they had that loss to Jackson achievement back in the beginning, he really just recollected himself, figured out what he was screwing up on, and is playing so much better.
Anything. There's nothing you could do to this Churro. He's completely untouchable, it feels, throughout this. I mean, look at this. Every time he gets hit,
no
he's healing
curse.
More.
No caster curse.
No caster curse.
Oh!
Oh, and then... Oh! Reflex, I'm afraid, from Vivid, and his Mario's out of this entirely!
What?
Churro, 3 stocks!
This is crazy. And look, he's still so aggressive. He doesn't let up. He sees his high percent, and most of the players are like, okay, I need to play safer. You know,
right. Luma's gone!
But he still looks for those opportunities, looks for those openings, and has been capitalizing them constantly.
Absolutely. And look at this. There's no counter. He's not offering anything. I've never seen this kind of safe and aggressive play, like you say. It's just...
Yeah.
And the Luma was gone for a moment.
Oh!
Off the stage! Completely gone! And that's game 2. Going over to the Futanari brothers. Churro, MVP by far.
Oh yeah.
What? I don't even know.
And I feel like Robert even can see this moment.
Yes.
Because he's spending a lot of time saving him. You know, like he
right.
says, oh, Churro's off the stage. He goes in. Distracts Mario, distracts Rosalina, gets him back on the stage.
Yeah. Quite a few times they're going for it, and it looks like Churro is in a real beef, but then ZSS comes in, it just distracts, gets the space there. Churro's back on, and the next thing you know, he's throwing someone for a loop. It's just, it's been such a fantastic ride, that game. I always kind of thought of Churro. Wait, we're already going in.
Yeah.
Wow, I don't even know. They're faster than us, apparently.
But as a possibly tournament stock.
Or a tournament game. Not stock.
Is.
That's
possibly.
But it's really interesting because, you know, I personally always kind of thought of Churro as backseating.
Yes.
In this team, the Futon Argo, I've seen them play a couple times. I always think Churro backseating. He's really taking the driving stick, whatever you want to call it.
Yeah. And even when he does make those mistakes, he's not letting it get into his head. He's not letting it ruin this mindset that he has.
Right.
And this momentum he's created with himself.
And look at this. Zubat's already 73% again. Same story, but ZSS also 5%.
Yeah, but they got Luma off right now. Oh, beautiful back air by Cho. Because he saw that Vivid had blocked the Zero Suit attack.
Right.
And then he saw him let go of that because he's like, okay, the pressure's gone.
Right.
But then Cho's like, no, it's not. Here's my feet.
Oh, and Vivid with a nice down smash, but it's not going to be quite enough. Oh, and he throws Brobear. Churro, excuse me, very far. It's not going to quite connect, though, and Luma's going to make it back on the stage. Both players flying every which way. Oh, and Brobear goes slinging
up. Down smash, but... this good down smash is pretty much all around.
Yeah, very good. They're just playing it very close, and Vivid's going to get the first blood, taking out Zero Suit Samus. And Churro kill!
So for the first time, for one of the few times, Taylor guys really have that lead. Rosalina's still 3 stocks.
Yep.
Yes, she's at a high percent, but I mean,
yeah,
she lives a long time.
She does. She absolutely does. And right now, that could be the Rosalina kill.
So blue team does have the percentage lead.
Just a little bit right now.
We've seen so much happen.
Absolutely.
And there's so much chaos that it's hard to really tell. And look at that, like just like that. It's absolutely even. They're just almost juggling them together.
And Luma's gone. Luma's gone, so now you just got the Rosalina. They're going back to the 1v1. They're going for the 1v1 here. Mario, and then the...
Rosalina Zero Suit.
Right, and it's working for them, except Vivith got a little bit of the better trade there on the Churro.
Yeah.
But Luma's back. They're going back to that kind of focus and set them up.
And I feel like this is definitely where the Futon Rose have exceeded this tournament, definitely.
Right.
When they space out the enemies and they get these... you know, I guess you said the 1v1s.
Right.
But the Tails and Greatest are doing a really good job at using this style against them.
Ooh! And a beautiful smash by Rosalina is going to crunch Zero Suit. Send her off stage.
Yeah, Churro misses the back air punish. Now he gets back on table. Good up smash. But just not enough percent to get the kill yet.
Yeah, not quite. Goes with the grab.
Oh! He had a steal. And the beautiful part is that he spaced out 2 jabs
right
to give that false sense of security to the Mario, which then caused him to drop the shield,
exactly,
punish the FB, and secure that kill.
It was such a great play there. And now the advantage is technically in favor of green team. Oh, never mind. Cast a curse once
back
again.
At it
so
again.
Sorry. And so now blue team ahead. ZSS pretty high on percentage here.
The thing is, if Zero can get a couple combos in with that up B,
right,
and maybe get a possible early kill off the right side or the left side, depending on where they're fighting,
right,
they can turn this around, but 100%, and then, you know, Churro's at 66 now.
Might not come down from that one, but he does.
Oh, the up smash fully charged.
Every time he comes back down, he gets hit again and again. And
they're really taking... Oh, and the back throw from Blue Mario's grab on Green Mario.
So now it's the 2v1. We've seen Churro...
He's played very well, but
I mean, this is a lot closer, well, a lot more disadvantage than anything else he's done.
Down smash,
and that's it.
That's great. Tell us they're not going to get 3-0'd, and they looked a lot better. The key difference, they started stronger.
Absolutely, they didn't give up a bunch of early percentage without returning anything, and Churro wasn't allowed to run quite as rampant as he had in previous games. So
I feel like I probably have to play my singles match.
Okay.
Because, I feel kind of bad.
Is there a console?
We'll see how this... Is there, like, a TV open, or...?
I don't see a TV open. Looks like they're all taken, currently.
Is there a TV open? Okay. No TV open. I'm safe.
We're safe, okay. Nobody
I
want to
watch
it. This
is
hype.
Yes.
It's exciting.
Definitely.
Down to the wire. This could be the last game, or it could be the start of something new.
Yes. And what I was saying with the early stock is because a lot of times we saw Vivid get to like 70, 80% just in like 10, 20 seconds.
Yeah, exactly.
And Rosalina would be at like 30, and Mario, the Churro would be like 0.
Yeah,
0, 10.
Yeah.
And they didn't let that happen. They took the percent lead.
Yeah, they took the percent lead, even if it was only by a few percent. It meant that Churro can't just couldn't take the risks. And he was still taking more or less those risks, but definitely they were getting a little more...
And if they can continue that again, I think there's a really good chance that they can continue this momentum.
Now, this is the one stage that they won with Little Mac, so I'm surprised he didn't sit back.
Well, I think it's just too scary when you're at that last... Cause
that's true.
Any other match, or any less losses with the Nine Brothers...
Right.
And they could risk it. But they are... They lost... They won one game, lost three with the Little Mac playing.
True.
And this could be tournament game.
Right.
So
and
you
now
don't want to have that chance.
Churro up to 63%. They're behaving much better, focusing, getting ready for Churro. Oh, look at that. Throw after throw after throw.
Oh, yeah.
It's just ripping through them right now. Rosalina just playing the back line, making sure everything stays safe. You
exactly.
Know? If something gets out of hand, she's gonna
kind of keeping them contained. You
exactly.
know, because like no one wants to go towards the Luma.
No, no one wants to go towards that.
Yeah, but Bivin is playing that middle so well again. You know, like exactly. You saw the three grabs in a row. He's
oh, and there's Mario. Dream Mario is coming.
Oh, Churro's out for stock. Great again, a better start from Tails of Greatness, and that's what really helped them get that lead early in the last game.
Yep,
and. Let's see if they can use that momentum. Rosalina up high, but safely lands. 0-2 definitely has the potential to close out these kills. And now we're going to see what team is the stage on.
Exactly, exactly. It looks to me like it's going to go after Vivid.
Rosalina down. Only took 36%, so that's not too bad for Churro. There's a lot of misses the uppy punish facing the wrong way.
But... There's the Mario on blue side going down 2-all except the Zero Suit. So if she can get off a really good combo before she gets stopped, it'd be good. Oh, and Vivid gets hit by that. No, he shielded it. Nice shielding by him.
Yeah, I feel like Vivid is just zoned in at this point. You know, like after when they were down 0-2,
oh,
see Vivid in his chair just deep breath.
We haven't heard the flex in a while. I
exactly.
think he's a little too focused.
And that's what they definitely did.
It's zoning in on Churro. Look at the Rosalina gets hit by the laser.
Takes a percent and loses Luma.
Yes.
Very unfortunate right there.
So, definitely. I think Churro played that right because he made sure the target stayed there and then jumped back right as Rosalina was trying to get back on
the
stage.
Those hitboxes are just...
Yeah.
Confusing. Yeah. It's so hard to tell, like, am I going to get hit?
Yeah.
Oh, I am.
Yeah, exactly.
Oops.
Especially since it's on an angle. Oh, and look at that.
Down.
Oh, I thought
Churro at a high percent.
Yeah, I thought for sure that Ninetales would go off as well there, but he doesn't. And Churro is really close to getting hit right now. And
that was kind of funny because when you grab Rosalina, Luma can wander out of it, right?
Exactly.
But Zero Suit stunned Luma.
Right.
So he couldn't. So Rosalina couldn't break free of it, but.
Yeah. Definitely. Ooh!
It's the Mario kill.
There's the Mario kill. It's
that's
so
huge.
Even. This is so close. There's so much going on.
Gets
Rosalina,
the kill.
Gets
Rosalina.
The Mario.
Very high percent.
This
beautiful side smash doesn't get the kill though. It's really gonna come down in these next few seconds. If Green Team can get the Rosalina kill and rack up some Crystal on Mario during that transition.
Absolutely. If that happens, this game is gonna be done, but the blue team has a slight advantage in the stocks. Rosalina taking to such a high percentage right now. And we could see something and that's going to give the advantage entirely to blue team in the 2v1.
And you cannot be happier because Mario's at low percent, Rosalina's 2 stocks, and you're
exactly.
the very safe character with 2 stocks. Vivid has been playing much better this game and last game. So, and you have so much control.
Very likely we're going to gank 5. Very
oh, yeah.
This is such an amazing turnaround. Vivid's just decided, hey, let's play this game.
Yeah.
And
it's so rare that you hear about the team that has three total wins.
Right.
Being the scary one when the other team is the 5.
Yeah.
In the course of these 2 best of 5s. And I just feel like the Little Mac games are kind of for fun. You know, like they were showboating and the Perry Bros really took advantage of that, really capitalized on that. When he switched to Mario, I think it was a mindset transition still, but Vivid has stepped up incredibly well.
Exactly.
And what else you might not see is Rosalina's control, and we were talking about how Rosalina's keeping them to Mario, you know?
Absolutely.
And that helped, it helps Vivid play his game.
Right, absolutely.
You kind of lose that, like,
Alright.
Are you leaving?
I sadly have to leave.
Alright, what game is adjourning?
Commentate.
Okay, executive decision from Grobert and Viviv. You've been demanded to stay.
I'm not allowed to play my singles match. It's the final game of the grand finals. Both teams have had comebacks. There's been crazy moments. There's been gifts. There's been beautiful reads.
You've been here.
Whatever team I think controls that early, the first stock kind of like lead, at least the percentage, I think they'll take it.
That's where it's bad. We've seen that every single game so far has just been which team can get that percentage, and so far up until these past two games, it's just Ventura.
Yes.
It's Ventura getting people up to high percentage, and he takes first damage here. So there could be, this might play out the same way, but last game was so close.
And blue team's getting those small hits off to get that percentage. And look at this, they're already at 45%, 40% at about 20 seconds in, you know?
Oh my gosh, look at Mario.
Blue team, the Tales of Greatness are just on a mission. And that's the thing, is like, because players play so much different when they're backed into that corner.
Absolutely. They do. And Vivis not giving up anything, and Rosalina, so much safer. It's a safe enough character as it is, playing so well to not take that.
Oh yeah, I mean, look at the percent, 90% Mario, Churro, 100% Brobert. 13% Rosalina.
And that's going to be it for CSS on the first stock. Completely gone.
They're blowing my expectations out of the water. Yeah. So I was thinking, they would have a percent lead, or they'd have to control the beginning, but they'd still take some damage. Rosalina's not taking damage.
No, they have a very, very, very clear, impressive advantage.
Oh, yeah.
It's just, this is unprecedented. They're just throw massive
down
comeback. And yeah, that's going to be it. They're up a stock all round. And oh my god.
Great punish, but they're just at low percents.
Yeah.
Over time.
It's a good punish, but I mean, you're already so far behind. That's, you need more than a good punish.
Oh yeah, and a beautiful little play right there. Seriously, was coming in for the forward smash, her double kick.
Right.
And it was going to hit Mario, but he realized he had enough frames to cape it and turn it around.
And the route into the back air, I believe, from CSS is going to finish off Mario.
Oh!
What?
Robert goes for a side B instead of. I must have been an error, and I think that really kind of shows the mindset, because they were up 2-0.
Yeah.
Commanding lead, commanding games. And ever since that, Tales of Greatness have turned it around.
Absolutely. There's some mentality change, obviously, Churro. And obviously they've gained control of Churro. Churro was untouchable for a long time. They've gained control of that, they brought it back down to so to speak.
And I think just Vivis strives on it, because we've been seeing it in his little back game, when it was the 1v2, and he almost won that game.
Exactly.
He strives being in that corner. He's really good at these high-pressure situations, and that's where the 0-2 brought him in.
Exactly.
He took a step back, he doesn't tilt, he doesn't get, he doesn't let it get in his head.
Uh-huh.
And he uses that, and we've seen it. His Mario has played exceptionally well.
These past two, and now three games, his Mario is as good as Churro.
Absolutely.
Maybe he can back up what he says.
Oh yeah, and what's crazy is that it's been so effective that Churro's still playing aggressive.
Right.
But it's like, where did the cleanness go? Where did the smoothness, kind of like the safe play? And it's because Vivek is getting rid of those options. He's making Churro play different.
Exactly. He's forcing him into his style of play, and that is. Oh, but the mistake there by
it's the show off. It's the show off.
Yep.
I mean, look at Churro's at 96%. Rosalina again, two stocks. Yara had two stocks. It's just this.
I think we are ready for the flex. Just about. We're going to see one here.
I'd be appalled if it didn't happen. But, I mean, beautiful one by the Food Nine Bros. Getting that early loss to Jackson and G-Man, turning that around, beating them convincingly, coming into the grand finals, taking the first specified very efficiently, getting the two wins up instantly against the Tales of Greatness. But you just got to give credit to the Tales of Greatness, it is a beautiful control, and the teamwork is there.
Absolutely. We weren't seeing it so much early on, but now they've come into their own, and they've shown us why they are the star of this tournament. Ladies and gentlemen, that is Grand Finals, going over the Tales in Greatness. Vivith and Ninetales take the entire tournament with a fantastic 10-game, well, not quite 10,
The two best of fives.
Two best
great
of
shows,
fives.
Great plays. All around fantastic grand match. You could not have asked for more.
Absolutely. And good luck in the tournament.
Yes, it's been a pleasure casting. This is Walt signing out. Simon will take good care of you guys.